Hey, it's Jerry with TradeTheFifth.com. I wanted to take you through a very simple trade in the E-mini Dow YM contract, thinkorswim. Let's see, Thursday we had a pretty good sell-off. We closed near the lows of the days. So in the opening session, the after-hour session, the Globex hours for the YM contract, we actually found a new low below the low of the day before. However, some good Chinese news came out and started driving the market back upwards. And you can see that we started pretty much driving from that point forward, coming into the non-farm payrolls time period, which is about 8:30 East Coast time, and that's right around where these multiple time frame dots turned blue. The news was extremely strong, about 2x the expectation on payrolls, indicating the U.S. economy was strong. We had a little bit of dip in futures, but right around that point, the bonds started selling off pretty hard, indicating that it was probably going to be a bullish risk on day. The bonds had been running upwards for quite some time, and I think this day set up to be pretty bullish. We're going to open with a big opening gap on the regular time hours session from the close in the prior day, some 300 points to the upside. The inventory, of course, overnight was going to be long. Everybody was buying at that point. Later in the day, also Jerome Powell, Ben Bernanke, and Janet Yellen were having a panel discussion. And given how Powell's last speech at the rate raise in December impacted the markets and how, let's say, negative the news was in terms of future rate hikes, sounded overly hawkish and took the market down. The thought was that he probably was going to back off from that a little bit and maybe be more data dependent. Inevitably, that's what happened. But really, the expectation going into the day with a big gap up was it probably would hold it and, you know, continue to seek prices higher. Everything seemed to give that indication. We had the overnight reversal on the 30-minute time frame. That's the anchor time frame for short-term trading that we're using. We did go from below the 30-minute cloud back up through it to green. So all the time frames started getting aligned at about 2 o'clock in the morning coming into the European Open. The European Open continued to help the U.S. market to go forward. A little bit of a pullback here at the 8:30 non-farm payrolls, but the market kind of absorbed that pretty strongly. And, you know, as we come into the 9:30 open here, my thought was that we might get continued short squeeze going into the open, and I'm looking for the potential of a scalping trade, trying to, you know, get one 100% times risk, maybe 200% times risk, which is what we ended up doing here. But inevitably, I had some trade logic for the day going into the day as how I was going to look at it, and be careful on getting in and out of a trade, especially near the open if one came to play that I would take. In this particular case, we did have a signal before the U.S. market open. I generally don't take those trades because the open can be pretty whippy, especially when you've got some overnight inventory long. So inevitably, I didn't take this signal, but I did look at and take this one here. So we at the open, we were pretty bullish, didn't really pull back even into the cloud. The ticks opened up extremely high. The bonds were continuing to sell off. Everything looked like it was, you know, lots of rocket fuel to the upside. So when this signal came up at this candle, I did set a trade entry here, a couple of contracts. This risk here on YM at $5 a point is about 51 or 2 points, something like that. So it's about $250 per contract. A couple contracts is a $500 risk. I generally don't trade on Friday like this, but I had, a number of conditions that I thought might be favorable for a quick scalping long trade. And inevitably, the next 3-minute candle, I was trading a 3-minute chart, by the way, as you can see up here. This 3-minute candle took me into the trade. It didn't really even come back towards the cloud. We ended up, I'm working on the coding of a future update to the indicator with a 100% times risk profit line. We did make a close above that line, so I moved my stop up to break even. We came down on the next candle, didn't break it, came up above the 100% line, and we're getting close to one ATR at this particular point. So when we hit the 200% line, I just took my trade off. The other reason I started looking at questionable how the trade was going to go, you can see the ticks are starting to make new lows, and the ticks are showing the amount of stocks being sold on the bid tick versus buying on the ask, and you start to see that it's starting to reach a little bit lower, a little bit lower, a little bit lower, indicating that there is some selling into the open. It didn't really make that much difference. We did end up, getting to a new low here, and we did have a pullback to the cloud. For those that do the cloud trading, we've talked about in other videos. You get a close inside the cloud. If you're thinking still long for the day, you could put an entry above the cloud with a stop below the cloud. In this case, that would have been another very successful trade in a 6 minute time frame. I don't know, it's 2074. Got up as high as 317. So I mean, that was a huge, huge trade if you would have taken that one as well. But inevitably, a 200% times risk, risk 500, ended up making about $1,000 on this trade here, which is pretty good for 15, 20 minutes worth of work. Pull back here, this one, 074 to 316. I mean, that's 200 and something points. Even one contract on this one, should you have taken a trade like that, would have been another very highly successful trade. Not one that I did. Again, I don't trade a lot on Fridays for futures. They tend to be kind of squirrely days. So really, all I ended up doing at this point was grabbing my points from this trade and ending the day. But there was a couple of pretty good trades here using the MTF dot cloud and the black box breakout indicator for the YM contract last Friday. Hopefully some of you were able to get into a trade like that and successfully grab some points for the day. Take care, guys. Bye.